Hey, good evening, guys. Been a while.
How's it going?
Good, good. Glad to be around.
purpose of this video is to acquaint pilots who are unfamiliar with the Bayport Aerodrome to the procedures in approaching and departing the aerodrome safely and without conflict with the Islip Class C airspace. The common traffic advisory frequency at the Bayport Aerodrome is 122.70. New York approach is 118.00 or 120.05, depending on which section you're approaching from. Here in this part of the video, we are departing on runway 36. We have a displaced threshold on runway 36, but you can use the entire runway for your departure. After we take off on 36, there is a commercial development just to the north of the airport. We fly over that. And then there's a housing development with 15 brand new luxury homes. If you can make a turn before you go over the houses, that's fine. If you can't, practice safe flying. Make your left turn to your crosswind lake, and then another left turn flying over the lakes, which you see here in the video. These are called the Sanssouci Lakes. Do not go above 700 feet. This is basically your downwind leg. We do not have closed traffic at the Bayport Aerodrome. Anytime you take off from the runway, you must fly your airplane all the way out to the Great South Bay, then turn around and come in, execute the proper approach procedure for the runway. We have a lot of traffic at the airport that does not use radios. We have many antique airplanes there that do not have radios, and we have students that take flying lessons. So please just remember that. But you can come to the Bayport Aerodrome without a radio. All you have to do is approach below 700 feet, and we have a keyhole cut out for us, and it's not a problem. Islip MacArthur Airport, which is located just north of our airport, is our controlling facility. You can call Islip, or if you call Flight Service, you can tell them that you want to know about NOTAMs for the Bayport Aerodrome. They'll be on the Islip NOTAMs. As you get down towards the Great South Bay, you can stay to the right. The river turns a little bit to the left right there, and you can stay to the right and stay away from the marina. This gives incoming aircraft some extra room. But when you approach to land on runway 18, you'll come straight up the river between the jetties. And you can call 122.7 and advise Bayport traffic over the shoreline for 18 Bayport. Or Bayport traffic, Cessna over the shoreline for 36 Bayport. That's all you have to say. If you look here, you'll see this big white house. You will fly directly over that house. It's below 700 feet, parallel the streets below, and fly all the way up to the school. Notice the school on the right-hand side, lower right-hand side of the screen. That's the Bayport High School. And we are going to fly up along the west end of that high school property. And when you look down, you'll see the Long Island Railroad tracks. You will make a right turn, and now you're on base, making a right turn onto base. So we have a left base to runway 36. A right turn onto a left base for runway 36. It's a very short base to final. Now we make a left turn to final, and there's our two runways. One runway will be closed, and the other runway will be used. They're generally marked with an X, whichever is closed, and the open one is the one with the white threshold markings, and generally where the other airplanes are landing. Don't hit the VASIs, please. The elevation of our airport is 42 feet. Okay, here we are. We're taking off on runway 18. Finally got off the ground. And all you gotta do is climb up to about 600 to 650 feet and go straight ahead. But anyway, if you look down, there's the nice houses down there. And again, once you get down to and cross the shoreline and you're over the water of the Great South Bay, you can go up to any altitude except above 1,500 feet. You must stay below 1,500 feet unless you call New York Approach and get clearance into the Class C airspace. Now, you can keep on going straight out to Fire Island, which doesn't really show up too well in the video, but it's only about 3 miles offshore, straight ahead. And once you get to Fire Island and cross the Barrier Island, then you can go up to any altitude you want. You're in uncontrolled airspace out there. Knock yourself out. Down there on the right, in the center of the screen, you'll see the jetties coming out by the entrance to where the ferry boats go in and out. And we're going to fly directly up that river. That river there is called Browns River. And that's going to give us the approach for runway 18. When you're about here, you'll call Bayport Aerodrome at 122.7 and say, Bayport, traffic, Navy, N3N, over the shore, 18 Bayport. Notice we're banking slightly to the right because the river does split. Up ahead, you'll see what they call the Sanssouci Lakes, if you will. And we're staying above those lakes. And just to the right of the screen, you'll notice now that the Bayport Aerodrome is in sight. You'll notice that when we start to parallel the runway, we should call Bayport traffic, Navy, downwind, runway 18 Bayport, because now you've entered downwind. And we're going to get ready to turn base. What we want to do is keep one thing in mind. Right down there where you see all that traffic, that's Sunrise Highway, Route 27 on your roadmap. We don't want to cross Sunrise Highway because that puts us in Islip MacArthur's airspace from the surface to 1,500 or to 700 feet. So we want to stay south of the Sunrise Highway. We are turning base and we're going to be turning final. You'll notice that your base to base to final is very short. It's almost a U-turn, especially if you have a tailwind from the west when you turn, or a wind from the west. So here we are lined up with the runways for runway 18. Be sure you land on the open runway. We expect you to do a good job.
When you're making your approach to runway 18, make sure you don't cross Sunrise Highway because you're going to go into airspace that we don't belong in. See? When you're taking off runway 18, make sure when you lift out, you don't go above what? 700 feet. You go straight out to the bay. Don't go left, don't go right. Big trouble. After you're out past the shoreline there, you can go up to 1,000 feet and not worry about it. See? When you approach, I forgot to tell you, when you approach from runway 18 from the water, make sure you come in over those two jetties. They're a good thing to line up on, and then follow the lake all the way down. The airport will be on the right side. See? And you make it back.
You know, last year, I couldn't even spell ABA. Now I are one.
Another thing, welcome guests. If you want to know any more, you call this number.
Thanks for coming in today, everybody. It's a special day for me. It's the 3-year anniversary of the Virtue USA Flying Club, and we're flying into Bayport tonight in our Cessna 152 from Farmingdale Republic. Quick hop, we'll land, we'll watch some of our buddies fly in, we'll have a good time. At the end of the day, I'll show a video of a real world Bayport flying that I participated in way back in 2014. Welcome. Thank you. Let's have some fun. We got a briefing in about 15 minutes in the Virtue USA Flying Club Discord for all the Flying Club members participating in tonight's event. And I'll be doing some giveaways later tonight for Flying Club members participating in the event. That'll all happen off the stream. Welcome. Settle in. Got about 15 minutes till the briefing. I'm going to let you enjoy the view of my 152. Coming soon. Alright, I'm back. Alright, like I said, we got about 13 minutes till the briefing. Open up our earphones to the Flying Club Discord. We're gonna get our final thing set up here. I don't need that. I need to show you guys this right here is what I'm doing. I'm just going to take off out of Republic. I'm going to fly right out to the Twin Span Bridge. I'm going to stay below the shelf here, below 1,500 feet coming out here, and then I'm going to get below 700 feet, make our way into the Bayport Aerodrome. If you were here at the start of the stream, you saw how we're getting in. It's going to be runway 18 tonight at Bayport. That is the more fun approach. A little bit of nice weather helping us along tonight. So that's going to be awesome. Got about 12 minutes till we do the briefing and get underway here. Expecting a big one. For those that haven't already saw, runway 18 at Bayport tonight. 18. Thanks for coming in today, everybody. Don't mind me, I'm just kind of jamming out. Chat, we got 10 minutes till the briefing.
Happy Mike. Someone pass the Cinnabons.
I'm on it.
Waiting, Michael.
They're on the way, they're on the way.
I gotta make my coffee.
I got K-cups.
Yeah, I got the good stuff for tonight.
How's Sarah?
She's good. She's actually right behind me right now, hanging out, watching the Mets game while I do this.
Let's go, Mets.
Tell her two things for me. tell her Anthony says hi.
Anthony says hi.
And let's go Yankees.
And he also said, let's go Yankees. What? Let's go Yankees. What? Let's go Mets, Jed. Mets. That's for later.
It's about the Mets, baby!
About 7 more minutes, guys.
Are you guys flying out of today?
Yeah, it's okay. Republic.
Republic.
You mean farming fail?
Peterborough.
Nice. Montauk. What's up?
I think I'm in New Jersey.
In Halliport.
Can I take a moment here and just say, welcome to the new division director for Bet USA.
Yeah, everyone be careful what they talk about tonight. We got some administration up in, Bet USA administration up in here tonight.
Oh, very cool. Welcome. Congrats.
Michael, the only person that I'm judging is you.
That's fair. That's the way it's always been. Almost
congrats,
time, Chad.
Thank you, my friend.
Every time one of us says something negative about the Yankees, our cert record gets longer.
Well, you should see Mike. Not only is he a Met fan, but he's also a Devils fan.
And a Red Bull fan, and a Minnesota Vikings fan. There's not a lot of winning in those franchises.
His cert record is so screwed.
Definitely not the Red Bulls.
Pretty guy that's departing out of Montauk. I'm actually departing pretty close to you. I'm departing out of Block Island. Oh, okay, yeah. I see you there on Batson. There's actually three of us sitting here on the ground at Montauk. Oh, I didn't connect yet. That's somebody else, but I'm connecting here in a second.
Briefing, we get started here about 3 minutes. About 3 minutes. Those that are listening currently, if you are able, after you land at Bayport, to kind of hang around on the ground, even if you have to leave the computer, just leave your sim running so you stay on the ground, make it look like a real fly-in with all the planes parked on the ramp, that would be great. I understand if you can, if your computer doesn't like that, or if you have to go away and turn the computer off, that's fine. But if you can, hang around after you land at Bayport just to kind of load up the ramp. It'll be quite nice.
No problem. Make for some good screenshots.
Exactly.
I'm actually thankful we landed runway 18 because in my scenery, the approach for runway 36 is blocked by a tree, so.
Oh, what the hell?
Congrats on 3 years, Mike. It's pretty cool.
Thank you. Should be thanking you guys for the 3 years.
You're welcome.
Two minutes.
Is anybody going to be streaming this fly-in?
I am up and streaming.
Nice. Anybody else?
I'll be streaming it.
Cool.
All right, chat. This briefing is coming shortly. We are going to pause the music, listen to a little bit of Flight Sim, and then we will be on our merry way. Hey, can one of the admin take care of the guy that just put in the waiting room about to start this briefing?
Yeah, I'll get it.
Thanks. Three so far.
Yes.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. Kenny Monster, thanks for coming in today. Exotics Lowells, thank you for the following. I appreciate you. Alright, it is 7:30 on the East Coast. Let's get this briefing going. Thank you everyone for coming in today. I see 35 in the channel. That's pretty impressive. Welcome to the first day of the new year for the Virtue USA Flying Club. It is the 3-year anniversary event. After tonight, we will be in year 4 of the Virtue USA Flying Club. Just a real quick background on the club. Started in August 16th of 2019. Built by myself and a handful of other NYARTCC members that were trying to revive some semblance of a general aviation flying club after the disappearance of the New York Flying Club from way back in the early days of VATSIM. I always felt that general aviation was something that was really lacking on the network and was very underappreciated, and the idea of the club was to kind of change that, kind of make general aviation come back to the forefront of VATSIM. And I think along the way, Audio for VATSIM definitely helped with that as well. It really kind of improved the environment for GA on VATSIM. And that's what the club is all about. It's promoting general aviation flying. We do these events to kind of spread the word and enjoy some of the more fun aspects of aviation. So welcome to the 3-year anniversary event. We are doing a Bayport fly-in, the Bayport Aerodrome. 2-3 November is in Bayport, New York, out on Long Island, right underneath the Clash Charlie of Long Island MacArthur Airport, or Islip Airport as you may know it as. I have done Bayport in real life a handful of times in terms of landing there in 152, which is what I'm actually personally flying tonight. I've also been to a handful of the rear world Bayport fly-ins. If you guys stick around, at least on my stream, I'll be showing clips from the fly-in in 2014 that I participated with Farmingdale State College in. So if you want to get a kind of a taste of what a real-world Bayport fly-in looked like at the time. But in terms of tonight's event, the big thing that you guys wanted to know and we have decided on is that it is going to be runway 18, so we get to do the nice tight turn approach to final into runway 18 at Bayport tonight. So it's going to be a lot of fun. Let's try not to bend too many airframes. If you have not already watched the approach and departure from Bayport Aerodrome YouTube video, it's required viewing, so make sure you get on that before you land in Bayport. It is important to realize that this is not a standard pattern. For runway 18 inbound, you're going to fly over the shoreline, right over the little port kind of inlet there. You're going to fly over the Sanssouci Lakes at or below 700, or I should say not at or below, I should say below 700 feet. And you're going to make that tight turn to final before crossing over Sunrise Highway. That will assure that you do not enter the Long Island MacArthur Class Charlie. Some of the big things to note is that because it is VATSIM, we are using 122.8, the normal Unicom, as our Unicom for this evening's event. There is a little bit of ATC going on in the New York area. I believe New York approach on 120.8 is covering everything. Now, if you're taking off out of an uncontrolled field, it does not matter, because you do not need to talk to anyone as long as you remain clear of airspace. But there are also a handful of towers. I know Republic Tower just came on. Westchester's got the tower on. If you guys are flying out, just be aware of that. And if you're flying out of Caldwell, Teterboro, pretty much anything like that, you're going to have to talk to New York approach on 120.8. But if you're coming from elsewhere, it's entirely up to you what you're flying, what you're doing. As long as you brought an aircraft that can get into Bayport, make that tight turn. I would hope to not see any bent airframes tonight. Big thing is the call-outs. We want to keep the call-outs to a minimum. The only two things that you have to report inbound to Bayport is when you're crossing over the shoreline and when you're on the right downwind. Those are really the only two things you have to call out from what I recall, even in the real-world thing. So you'll say, Bayport traffic, says the 124 Mike Charlie, shoreline for 18 Bayport. And then the next call will be Bayport traffic, says the 124 Mike Charlie, downwind, runway 18 Bayport. That is it. Those are the only calls you have to make. The other thing that we need to know about this airport is that we really need to have space going in because of the tight turn, because it's a small strip. So if someone is calling over the shoreline, the next person should not be entering the shoreline until that person has called that they are in the downwind for 18. So when a person says that they are downwind for 18, the next person up can then call over the shoreline inbound. There's going to be a lot of traffic in the Great South Bay getting into Bayport tonight with a bunch of us flying in. Make sure you're using Unicom. Keep vigilant. See and avoid. Be generous. If you see that someone's lowering in front of you and ready to go and get in, talk it out on the Unicom. That's what it's there for. And make it known who's going to be next going into the field. Just try not to have any mid-air collisions over in the Great South Bay. Otherwise, you're welcome to fly in. You're also welcome to fly out if you want. If you're flying out off of runway 18, you just depart straight out to the shoreline. Make sure you stay below 700 feet until you cross over that inner shoreline and get over the Great South Bay.
Mike, I have a question with
you. Hang on 1 second on the question. Let me finish through this. For anybody who hasn't looked yet, I did create a temporary channel for the event tonight. It is the anniversary event attendance giveaway temporary channel. It is right below the events channel in the Discord. After you land at Bayport, please put your information into that channel. Whether you want to be involved with the giveaway or not, I need that you guys to fill out when you land at Bayport so I can get a proper count for the event tonight. So my example is there. You put your call sign, the route that you flew, the time that you land in Zulu time, and if you want to be eligible for the giveaways, let me know what you want to potentially be able to win. If you want to win a Virtuosa Flying Club hat, you'll put hat. If you want to win a gift card, you put gift card. If you want to win, and this is for the Honeycomb Bravo Throttle people only, if you want the flap level detent that our buddy Daniel Skidmore has made for us, custom made, then you would put flaps. You can put one, two, or all three, whatever you want to win, make sure it's listed on there when you put that information. And make sure, whether you want to participate in any of those giveaways or not, that when you land at Bayport, you put that information in there. That'll help me get a count, because it's going to be otherwise pretty hard to eyeball it. Just in general, with the amount of people that are flying in. And then the last thing I want to say is, and I talked about this a little bit right before I started the briefing, once you land at Bayport, if you can hang around, even if you have to leave your computer, but just stay parked on the ramp, make it look like a real fly-in so we can get screenshots of all of us on the ground later on once everyone starts to get inbound. That'd be great. If you can, I understand. Trust me, I know some people's computers are finicky. Even mine every now and then gets a little wonky at times. But if you can hang around, that'd be great. And we can get a nice big group picture. I'm on Microsoft Flight Sim, so I don't have great model matching. For those people that are in X-Plane that do have great model matching, I'm going to rely on you guys for the screenshots. Get screenshots, post them, Flight Sim pics, as many as you can. If we can get enough good pictures, I plan on making a nice big 3-year anniversary post on the VATSIM Facebook page to kind of help to promote the club and express my gratitude to you guys as well for participating tonight. All right, John, what's your question?
In the past in these events, sometimes we get stacked out over that Great South Bay. Is there a proper holding pattern we should be, kind of conforming to?
No, there really isn't. It's kind of just see and avoid and just kind of work your way around that bay and just everyone kind of be friendly. If you see that someone's closer to the entry, let them go. If you have a bunch of fuel and you're not really in a rush, then kind of lay back and let people move in until you get your opening. But there's no real set thing. Same with when the Bayport flying happens, real world, just kind of see and avoid. Try not to hit anyone and, you know, be courteous.
Thanks, Mike.
Does anybody else have any other general questions?
I don't have any questions, but I did want to mention in the event channel, I put a link to a pretty helpful graphic for the Bayport traffic pattern. So if you take a look at that as well, it's a nice overview to kind of go along with the video.
That is very helpful. Thank you.
Are there any other questions?
Yes. Where did we get the video? So I can my first line.
In the briefing, so if you go to the events channel and you scroll up to the original event post, you're going to have to scroll up a little bit. I posted it on like July 29th. If you go to the briefing, the text briefing, in there will be a link to a YouTube video called Approach and Departure from Bayport Aerodrome. That is the video you're going to want to watch, and you're going to want to retain the information for runway 18. Are there any other questions? Gentlemen, right now I see 35 of us in this Discord. That is a good number. Hopefully we can somehow squeak out 10 more people that weren't here for the briefing that do fly in tonight, because then we can tie the record. Either way, it's going to be a great show. I look forward to seeing you guys on the ground at Bayport. Fly safe. Don't bend an airframe. Have fun. Make sure you guys post in that anniversary event channel after you land. And I plan to run the giveaways as soon as everyone's complete. The cutoff is 9:30. If you do not have your information into the channel by 9:30, you will not be eligible for the giveaways. So make sure you have your information in by 9:30. If you do land after 9:30, that's fine. Put your stuff in there. You just won't be eligible for the giveaway, but you'll still be put into the event count, if that makes sense. So please, please, please make sure you guys take care of that. So that way at 9:30, I can start compiling the drawings, start running the giveaways, and start contacting the people who win. And whoever wins, I will obviously post the screenshot for the drawing in the GA chat like I always have for past giveaways. Have fun, guys. See you on the ground at Bayport.
See you.
See you.
See you. Put a briefing. See you.
Mm-hmm. If you need a paper traffic pattern of Bayport, I put it in the GA chat.
All right, chat. Let's do it. Let's get this baby fired up.
Bayport traffic, helicopter break down to hotel, Hampton from Bayport.
Alright, make sure good. We'll go ahead and do let's see, quick primer. Clear left, clear right, clear prop.
Yeah, the same thing earlier. It wasn't connecting to voice frequencies.
Here we go. Looks like we have Republic Tower online for us on 118.8. So let's go ahead and get him squared away. 118.8. Beauty out here real quick. Let's see what the ATIS is at Republic real quick. It is ATIS Alpha. Using runway 19. Alright, so we're gonna taxi out to runway 19. That is the wrong freaking thing. Pull that taxiway diagram up so I know how to get to 19. It's been a little while since I've done some Farmerdale things. Go ahead and remove the parking brake. We'll go pull up to the end of the taxiway here. No, I just something? That'll help us out. Public Tower, good evening. Cessna 124, my Charlie Echo ramp request taxi VFR to the southeast.
Cessna 124, Mike Charlie, Farmingdale Tower, runway 19er, taxi via Papa Bravo, cross runway 14 at Bravo, Bravo 1.
All right, Papa Bravo, cross 14 at Bravo, Bravo 1 to 19, Cessna 124, Mike Charlie. Yes, we are at Republic, Kitty Monster, Kilo Foxtrot, Romeo Golf. Everybody watching the stream, thanks for coming in today. Happy to have you here. Alright, we're clear to cross. Clear left. Clear right. Yeah, a handful of NYARTC controllers online, but I know that also a large handful of them will be flying in towards the latter half of the event as well. So they're kind of doing double duty. And I appreciate them for that. How crowded we can make things on the ground over at Bayport.
And Farmingdale Tower, good evening. Bonanza 718, Quebec November, Echo Ramp, VFR departure, southeast.
Bonanza 718, Quebec November, Republic Tower. Runway 19er, taxi via November Alpha 2, Charlie.
We're going to do a very
Bravo,
quick run up here.
Bravo 1, cross runway 14 at Alpha 2.
Stop right here. We'll get the RPM up. 2,000 RPM. And we'll do a quick run up. It's 2,000 RPM.
Tower. That's a 7-8 Quebec number. Taxi,
right,
November,
right mag first.
Charlie, Bravo,
don't
Bravo
draw.
1, Charlie,
back
cross
bolt.
14, or sorry, Bravo 1,
left
cross
mag.
14 at altitude.
Note the drop, back to bolt, pull the carb heat, note the drop, full, quick, easy, painless run up, airplane is good, we're ready to go. Cessna 124, Mike Charlie is ready for departure.
Cessna 124, Mike Charlie, make a straight out departure to the south. Wind 15010, runway 19er, clear for takeoff.
All right, departure south, 19, clear for takeoff, Cessna 124, Mike Charlie. Here you go, chat.
And FYI to those of you who are listening, New York Approach is going to close in about 10 minutes.
You can still talk to Kennedy Tower, right? Transition under the Bravo at 500 feet along the beach.
That's correct.
No one heard me? Mike, did you hear me transmit on sound?
Negative.
Why is this not working?
Is that you sitting on November?
No.
Alright, we're gonna turn out here towards Twin Span Bridge. We're gonna hold about 1,000 feet.
I know.
A320 is treating me good, Kitty Monster. And I am treating it good for the most part. I've had a few rough landings, but for the most part, I've been treating it very nicely. Thank you for asking. I'm enjoying it very much. That JetBlue schedule is a little rough, let me tell you. Some of those
public tower check, 874 Alpha ramp with Alpha ready to taxi.
You're
express
good.
A Gulf 4 intersection departure.
Very good.
Number 3974. Public Tower, runway 19er, taxi via Delta Gulf.
So we'll maintain 1,000 feet,
and
that'll keep us below that outer shelf of the
Gulf intersection.
Iceland
class
Charlie,
Gulf
and when we get closer to Bayport, we'll make sure
we
are below.
Gulf 4 intersection, absolutely, runway 19er at Gulf 4, taxi via Delta Gulf, Gulf 4.
Okay, runway 19er at Gulf 4, taxi via Delta Gulf, Gulf 4 for Cherokee 83974.
Once again, if one of the other admin that maybe hasn't taken off yet is able to help that guy in the waiting room.
Hey, Anthony, I know you're supposed to be, Mike was saying, to file a flight plan for everybody who's going. You don't have one and you want me to put one in for you?
No.
Okay, I mean, I don't... If it's just that you need something with the destination, I can totally just do that right now.
Boss gonna have some time to X-Plane. I'm sure I'll have some time, Penny Monster. When is X-Plane 12 supposed to come out, by the way? Is there a drop date for that yet, or do we not have a release date for that yet? Change proof for my Charlie suit.
No, I don't see one. I can just put it in for you if that's easier. It takes 3 seconds sometimes versus trying to do the website. Oh, there it is.
Twin Span Bridge.
See, it had a typo.
Coming up in.
It's showing up right now.
Bay. We're Wait. Heading out over towards the Bayport River.
I assume I'm still good.
You are still good to taxi, absolutely.
Sound good, Kenny Monster? I'll see you in a bit. area. I know so well. This South Shore, Long Island, Great South Bay. This is where I did all my. I just realized I had the window open the whole time. Which you can do. You can fly these planes with the window open, no problem. So, I don't think we're breaking any rules there. I just found that funny that I left it open. But I did all my flight training out here on Long Island, so very familiar with the area. Been into Bayport in real life. I think I've done 4 landings or 5 landings at the Bayport Aerodrome in real life, so I've done the grass strip landing there a handful of times. All of them in 152s and 172s, so all in Cessnas. Bayport traffic, so Cessna 124, my Charlie is about 10 out, planning on 180. See just barely on the horizon there another aircraft out in the bay that we're really gonna probably follow on the way into Bayport here. She should probably
be. Bayport number percentile altitude, go shoulder line and down runway 18, full stop Bayport.
There it is. Oh, I didn't put the landing rate meter on, let me do that.
And Bayport traffic, Douglas 410 Hotel Alpha is 10 miles. West inbound for 18.
See what my
Bayport
landing's gonna be tonight.
Bayport traffic number 75 left tango is joining the downwind for runway 18 Bayport.
Down below that 700 feet as we get closer here.
Bayport traffic, November 7th, off Tango is going to be turning red base for runway 18, full stop Bayport.
Wait, Del, that's what my model matching is matching as, Anthony.
Somebody's open mic.
Coming up to the inlet here, chat right here. Right where my mouse is.
Bayport traffic delivers 75 off Tango is going to be clear runway 18.
Yeah, I don't actually hear the hot mic.
Me too.
So we're below 600 feet, chat. I'm going to go ahead and, before I forget, pull the carb heat, get that ready to go before we start our descent here. We're going to lose a bit of RPM, but that's all right. Start getting ready for our approach into Bayport. follow this little river to the lakes. Bayport traffic, Cessna 124, Mike Charlie, Shoreline 18, Bayport. And the fun begins. Right over the San Susi Lakes. We don't want to go too far to the left because we don't want to go over those luxurious homes of Bayport and make too much noise, and then we have to make sure we turn our final before we cross Sunrise Highway on the north side. Deal, Kenny Monster. I'm doing this by the book. I am not a sellout. Bayport traffic, Cessna 124, my Charlie, downwind 18 Bayport. Getting a little slow here. We will get full flaps before we do our base to final turn. So we're downwind. There's the field right there. We're looking good. Probably don't want to get too much lower than this right now. And let's just make sure we don't cross Sunrise Highway. There is Sunrise Highway right out in front of us. We can start a turn here momentarily. Flaps all the way in, I'll start my turn. Oh, plenty good. Better Bayport turns I've made in a while in the sim. See very clearly which runway is open and which one is not. Carrying a little bit of excess speed, but we got plenty of room to get this 152 down. We'll make it nice and smooth. 92.
Bayport traffic, Douglas 410, Hotel Alpha, over the shore, 418 Bayport.
Like that, we have arrived at the Bayport Aerodrome. Thank you for the 100 bits, Kenny Monster. I appreciate you. I gotta take care of something for you, real quick, too. Give me a second here. I'm gonna go take my rightful spot in front of the hangar. I think I've earned it. Being the founder of the Virtue Safe Flying Club. Beautiful spot one. Right there is good. Set the park and brake. We're gonna keep the engine running, chat, because I need the battery to stay alive. So we can listen everyone coming down without the battery dying. What I will do is I'll turn all the lights off except for the nav lights stay on since I have the engine running. We're going to go into the drone cam here in a second. Let me get Kenny Monster his...
Bayport traffic, Chancellor 3499, Mike, over the shoreline 18.
His monthly subscription to the channel. Since he is a fantastic admin of the channel. There you go, Kenny Monster.
Kenny Monster.
Spreading those emojis.
Bayport traffic, Douglas 410, Hotel Alpha's on the right downwind, 18, Bayport.
Get into that showcase cam here and go find our nice little spot. Watch the arrivals, chat. I think right here is going to be a nice spot. This is kind of like where you would stand if you were watching the real fly-in, like right here in this little tree line right here. There's usually a bunch of seats and everything, like right here. So we'll use this as our viewing point for the aircraft that are coming inbound right now. And we'll sit here and we'll just kind of watch and observe and listen to some of the Virtue Safe Flying Club members as they fly in. What time did we land? About roughly 0001 Zulu.
Bayport traffic, November 70 Bravo, over, over.
Further down to watch the landings, and we're gonna do it from this side as well. We're gonna change it up a bit, a little bit further down. Actually, I want to see them making a turn, so let's see. We'll do it from right here. I think this is a good angle to watch the inbounds coming.
Bayport traffic, Chancellor 349 on Mike is right down from 18 Bayport.
Nobody wants the hat so far.
And Bayport traffic, Bonanza 718, Quebec November, South Shore, inbound 18, Bayport traffic.
Bayport traffic.
What happened
Bonanza
to Walker?
November 7th here, Bravo.
He's coming out, they're
right.
Just putting Trevor Williams into the game. Are you telling me that Walker is hurt Bayport now traffic. Too? Are we really about to stack up all these injuries right now?
I know Mike is already established on the right down 118.
Do you want to turn the AC off? The clicker should be over there, the white one. You can turn the power off on the AC. Ay. Mets are starting to rack up the freaking injuries, chat. It's not good. Since you're not paying attention, I gotta ask Twitter. Yep, back-to-back games, Mets starters got injured in the second inning. Yes, that is the lady friend you see in the background. Everyone say hi to Sarah. Sarah waves hi. Let's see the aircraft coming in right now, chat. Yeah, I think this is a good view, actually. I think it's a perfect view. Alright, I am going to step away from the computer real quick. I will be right back.
Paper Chelsea, Beach Crest.
Enjoy the show.
7-0 Bravo, making right turn final for 118.
Traffic 8W. Helicopter 38 Delta Hotel is parallel taxiing to runway
18. Bayport traffic, Beach Crest, November 7th, Sierra Bravo is vacated, runway 18.
Bayport traffic, helicopter 8 Delta Hotel, runway 18, straight out.
8-4 traffic, Sky Lane 616 New Papa is 10 miles to the southwest. It will be inbound for 18, 8-4.
Bayport traffic, Bonanza 718 Quebec November, at the marina, right downwind, 18, Bayport traffic.
Alright, Chad, I'm back. I just had to get myself some snacks while I watch the inbounds coming in. Let's take a look at Vat Spy and see what's going on. Oh yeah, it's already nice and busy along the south shore here, Long Island. You got a handful of us on the ground already, and a bunch of people on the way in. Look at that whole crew coming in. Oh man, big handful of folks coming inbound. Like to see it. My snack is a Mexican spice brownie. Probably would be better if I reheated it. Still a good pull up. Alright, chat. Here's what we're gonna do. There's only a handful of you watching me anyway. I've already done my flight. This stream was always gonna be short. I'm gonna leave you with the video from a real world Bayport fly-in that I participated in 2014 when I was still at Farmingdale State College. I'm going to put that video
Bayport
up.
Bayport traffic, White Cherokee, shoreline inbound, right down 118, Bayport traffic.
And when I do that, I'm going to kind of kill the sound for everything else, including the sim and all that. And we're going to kind of just have the video. I'm going to go off camera. I'm going to turn my mic off. I'm going to play the video. I'm going to end the stream after that. We'll raid someone, probably Slant Alpha Adventures, since he's flying in. We'll raid him. So enjoy the video. Thanks for coming in today, guys. For any of the Flying Club members, thank you for being part of the Virtue Safe Flying Club and the 3-year anniversary event. Really appreciate you guys.
And Bayport traffic, Bonanza, expect number.
Oh, the Mets are losing.
Gave
up a home run. Aye, aye, aye.
Bayport traffic.
Alright. Have a great night, guys. Enjoy the show. Enjoy the video. Let me get it set up here.
Welcome to the Antique Airplane Club of Greater New York's Fly-In 2014. The weather was great and the turnout was even better. Hello, Gerard. Stand back, Captain Dick is a professional. Ready for the day's activities, the pilots had a meeting to find out how they can screw up the entire situation. Watch out for these two. They're up to something stupid. Nigel and Graham are hitting the skies for their attempt at greatness.
Gentlemen, currently, Craig Sampson in the Yak 52 is in last place both in spot landing and bomb drop.
Oh, I totally got it, but I'm having fun. Missed the target by miles and landed halfway down by the Pacific.
hit you with a shoulder harness. Down your left.
Mike in Bay 40, you the last one in?
Yeah, I believe so. I'm right downwind right now.
Okay, I'm coming in behind you, the X. Landing approved.
Not even close.
Actually, it was close. Telling me in French, you won.
I didn't get to throw out the inflatable sheep. I'm pissed.
Where is he?
Roger, Yak in the downwind, and copy runway clear.
We should pull up to the pool and throw a bomb in.
We got one.
You know what? I'm gonna do the bombing contest while we're taxiing. Now we gotta throw the sheep out too.
We gotta get it in.
I thought we'd be taking 20.
Roger. Got over the board, big boy. Good job, brother.
All right.
I almost got the touch down.
Nigel and Craig are off in the Yak for a spin around the patch.
Geo, Geo, yeah, I'm doing just great. Music is my escape. Y'all can miss me with that flashiness. Now that's the shit I don't play. Ain't on tour, but I'm on my way to that Rolls Royce with that drapes. Need no handouts from you flakes. Been on my own, I'm doing okay.
Airplane before he dropped the bomb into it.
Brooks, congratulations.
Thank you.
Make sure you try and join us for the 2015 fly-in. It was now time for the first annual Post-Antique Airplane Club of Greater New York fly-in golf cart race.
Number 7.
Seriously?
There's 20 out there that's pretty full functioning. If you have a little bit of a lesser computer, then something like P3D or FSA.